Evan Agostini, Envision, AP, Gusek, photoajo_com, Shuttershock, Katie Martin, The Atlantic in an interview with Goop.com, Gwyneth Paltrow's lifestyle company, a former cable television technician named Clint Ober explained the practice of earthing, or walking barefoot on the ground. What he seemed to drop from his experience in cable systems was that, not unlike live wires, humans' electrical charges could be neutralized through contact with the earth. Doing so, he explained, prevents inflammation-related health disorders. It's intuitive that, like in a cable system, grounding would neutralize any charge in the body. After grounding myself, and a few friends who had arthritic-type health disorders, I became convinced that grounding could reduce chronic pain. Help readers reap these supposed health benefits without having to touch their bare feet to the ground. The Goop article provides a link to bedsheets and mats that can be plugged into the grounding port of an electrical outlet. A queen-sized sheet goes for $200. The post claims several people in the Goop community, including GP herself, swear by earthing for everything from inflammation and arthritis to insomnia to depression. But Truth in Advertising, a consumer advocacy group, cited earthing in a database of 50-some instances in which Goop promoted unsubstantiated products or claims. Last month, Truth in Advertising urged two California district attorneys to investigate Goop and take appropriate enforcement action. It's far from the first time Goop's medical advice has been called into question. Yet by outward appearances, it's still a very successful media company. It's June, and Goop Health Summit, crammed with crystals and aura photographers, sold out of its $1,500 tickets, and there are two more like it scheduled. Each month the site is read by 1.8 million people, people who have the very advertiser-pleasing characteristics of an average age of 34 and a household income in the six figures, according to Adweek. In April, Goop announced it was teaming up with Condé Nast, which publishes The New Yorker, Wired, and other prominent magazines, to create a quarterly print publication debuting this month. According to People magazine, in the inaugural issue, Paltrow's editor's letter describes the joys of cleanses, beasting skin treatments, and, of course, barefoot strolls. "For me, when I take my shoes off and walk in the grass, it's so healing. It's hard to find scientific evidence for the idea that I feel good. But by trying, you get so much juice out of life." Goop did not respond to multiple requests for an interview. In a statement provided to The Hollywood Reporter, Goop said, "While we believe that Truth in Advertising's description of our interactions is misleading and their claims unsubstantiated and unfounded, we will continue to evaluate our products and our content and make those improvements that we believe are reasonable and necessary in the interests of our community of users." How to explain Goop's popularity? In many ways, it exemplifies, and has capitalized on, several recent trends in health media. Fact-checking often doesn't fit into increasingly tight media budgets, or isn't much of a priority, so dubious health claims about prolonged fasting or avoiding gluten ricochet around the internet. The rich are already more likely than the poor to be healthy, so they shell out for alternative treatments and supplements, in hopes of achieving even greater vitality. And as news consumers increasingly seek out their own preferred sources, finding reliable expert advice becomes a choose-your-own-adventure game. Or, to use a Goop IER word, journey, ". When it hits newsstands later this month, Goop magazine will join a large roster of celebrity-blessed lifestyle publications, following in the footsteps of Oprah Winfrey, Martha Stewart, Rosie O'Donnell, and Rachel Ray. The idea behind celebrity-led publications, says Brooke Aaron Duffy, a Cornell professor who researches women's magazines, is that celebrities were not just individuals we saw on the screen, but we had a connection to them. We could emulate them in our everyday lives. By some measures, it works. Dr. Oz, The Good Life, and O, The Oprah Magazine were both top 10 monthly magazines at newsstands last year, according to the trade publication Min. The print magazine and events business are part of a broader shift in how women's publications position themselves. With news media profits shrinking, publications want to be a cross-platform brand, a place that people will come to even if the print publication no longer exists. Duffy said, Rachel Ray, for instance, has her own line of products, and Cosmopolitan hosts events, as does The Atlantic. Goop has its own online shop complete with pictures of Paltrow sporting whimsical tops. Goop gives soul-cycling, chia-chomping young people a place to ramp their zen to the next level. For a media company, Goop already seems to be doing relatively well. Revenue reportedly tripled between 2015 and 2016. That year, Paltrow announced she had raised $10 million from venture capitalists. The site may be benefiting from a growing interest, at least among wealthy Americans, in all things healthy-ish. organic food sales have grown, well, healthily over the past decade. Even Gatorade now comes in an organic variety. Nearly 10% of Americans do yoga, and 8% meditate. People are skipping soda for mindful beverages like coconut water. Americans now spend about a third as much out of pocket on complementary practitioners as they do on regular doctors. Millennials, in particular, are more likely than older Americans to say health means more than just not being sick. Goop gives many of these soul-cycling, chia-chomping young people a place to ramp their zen to the next level. One health reporter and editor who has worked at various women's magazines suggested that Goop's fun approach to wellness might be more appealing to readers and advertisers than more serious health fare, such as how to prevent diabetes or avoid the flu. Goop already has a readership built in, she said. Plus, Gwyneth Paltrow is an interesting figure and really beautiful,